relation between the two. So we want to look at the relationship between Hickson demand and the Marshallian demand. Now, analytically, the problems look very similar. Marshallian demand was fixing up your budget line and then finding the indifference curve tangent to it. And Hickson demand was fixing your indifference curve and finding the budget line tangent to it. Okay, so if this budget line and indifference curve combination is such that this U star becomes same as this U naught here, or if the income here becomes the same as the budget you calculate in this case, then in either of the cases, the calculated point should be the same. Okay, so if income that you are finding in Marshallian case was same as the budget which you find out in the Hickson case, then effectively the point must have been the same. Okay, because technically the problem is just finding the tangency. Okay. So that's the idea of this relationship. This relationship says, the first point is, so Xi means Marshallian demand, XIH means Hickson demand. So this is Marshallian and this is Hickson. So Marshallian demand, when prices are P and income is I, is same as Hickson demand when prices are P and you make the consumer reach a utility level V, which he was reaching with this income and prices. Okay, so to understand this, let's take a hypothetical situation. So you are a person who has some income I and some prices P. And given this, you were earning a utility level V. Okay, now there's this government, new government, which comes into power, which says that we'll not pay anyone, we'll give everybody bundles. So instead of giving you money, everybody would be paid in bundles. So they will give you whatever commodity you need. Now this government's proposal is they will make you indifferent between the new situation and the old situation. So the government should give you this much amount of utility. Now to give this much amount of utility, the government does an expenditure minimization problem. So what has happened is, the government has taken away your income. Government says, ki, I will give you a bundle X, X here, such that you will receive the same level of utility which you were getting earlier. I'll make you indifferent, don't worry about it. I'm not giving you money, but I'll give you bundles. So let's say I give you rupees 10,000. Whatever you buy in this 10,000, you gives you some utility. So if I say I'll give you bundle which meets this utility criteria, you must be indifferent. I'm like, okay, take as long as I'm on this utility. So if this government chooses this Hickson demand to reach the same level of utility, and assuming that the prices are same as earlier, then it will effectively be giving you the same bundle which you were buying earlier. So whatever it is he's giving to you, this government is giving to you, is the same bundle which you were buying earlier, solving your utility maximization problem. Okay, so basically this whole futility of cancelling out the income and giving this guy bundles, that's what this assumption is. Okay, this relation is. Alright, the second relation is important. The second relation claims that suppose you give a person you some Hickson bundle in order to reach a utility level U, and in order to do that you are doing some expenditure on this person E. Okay, so the government decides to run some PDF shops, and in this PDF shops the government is giving some bundle in order to reach a level of utility. Suppose this is a PDF shop, and in this PDF shop there's this government representative who's giving you a bundle X Hickson. The aim of this bundle is to make you reach a level of utility U when prices are P, and in doing so this government, it encounters an expenditure E. Okay, so what this problem says is that Instead, had the government given this entire expenditure what it is getting to you in your bank account, then you would be buying a bundle which is the Marshallian demand XI for prices P and income level E. And these two things will be same. Okay, so basically, whatever bundle you are giving to this guy through PDS, if instead of giving this bundle, whatever expenditure you are doing on giving this bundle, you transfer this expenditure to the guy's account, he will also be buying the same bundle from the shop. Alright, so this is basically the futility of PDS. This is something which has been realized a long time back. Okay, PDS is not perfect. Okay? And that's why we are moving to direct benefits transfer. The whole concept of DBT is, instead of giving this guy bundle, give the money in his account. That is direct benefits transfer. And let him buy the bundle. Why do you want to hire this person to do this? Why do you want to own this shop to do this? All this is expenditure. This E is just the expenditure on purchasing the bundle. This is what we call in economics as the procurement cost. This E is nothing but the procurement cost. The procurement cost is the cost that you actually spent on buying the bundle. Procurement cost in different states ranges between 40% of the total cost to 80% of the total cost. In some states, it is, which are very efficient, 80% of the total cost of running PDS is just procurement cost. But in some very inefficient states, only 40% of cost is procurement cost. The rest is transportation, hiring people, storage and distribution channels, etc., etc. So everything is, so if you are spending 100 rupees, only 40 rupees is going to the consumer. 60 rupees is just day-to-day expenses. So that 60 rupees is a waste of money. Instead, ye 40 rupees tum logo ke account mein dal do, 40 ki 50 dal do. You will be saving money, they will also be happier. Okay, but obviously there are problems with DBD. One obvious problem is, here you are giving him ration, you are giving him wheat, you are giving him oil, you are giving him kerosene. Here you give him money, he'll buy alcohol. He'll put it in gambling. And these are very serious problems. So there are different techniques which the government is engaging in, like direct benefit transfers, but conditional on you spending it on these things. So let's say in January, you get your 1,000 rupees. Okay, now the government does not care where you spend it, but only if you spend just 1,000 rupees on wheat, etc., only then you will get the amount again in February. Otherwise, you will get nothing. If you don't spend this 1,000 rupees on wheat, etc., using your ID or Aadhaar or whatever, then we won't give it. Okay? So that's why there is some need of verification that this 1,000 rupees is going to the actual person. It's not going to some fake account which is created by some politician or bureaucrat. So that's why you need a biometric mechanism to analyze that only the correct person is getting it. So that's why you need a biometric assisted Aadhaar. Because Aadhaar card can only be generated for a biometric. If you don't have an eye, you cannot get an Aadhaar. If you are not a person, if you are a fake person, you won't have an eye, you cannot get an Aadhaar card. Okay, so that's why DBT was contingent on biometric. Because if you make it non-contingent on biometric, then a lot of fake profiles will be generated by bureaucrats, and then you will be transferring money to people who don't actually exist. Benami accounts. Okay, so that was a problem, but Aadhaar solves that problem. So with Aadhaar, the government is trying to get more and more into DBT, direct benefits transfer. Okay, another way to do it is what Brazil is doing. Brazil says, I'll give you money as long as your children are in the school. Okay, if your children get out of school, I'll stop giving you money. Another thing which Brazil inspired others to do, and a lot of other countries are doing now, is instead of transferring it to the male, they only transfer it to the female. females are less likely to spend the money on gambling and alcoholism if they have kids. So if there are children, the female is more likely to spend it on the nutrition and education of the children. So instead of transferring the money to the male, they are transferring to female. So these are some real life challenges. So theoretically, we study a lot of things, which finally ये तो होना चाहिए क्यों नहीं होता है? There are some real life executional pains with DPT, which the government is as economists learn, they suggest new things to the government, and then the government kind of in this new information, it changes the way things operate. All right.